hate the loading times on this. It's not like the original. Thought I'd take a look at this one. Made a couple families. I know I named the sim for this one Casey. It's just one sim. And I gave her a little Dalmatian puppy. I forgot what I named him though. I think I called him Two-Tone. Well, we'll see. Okay, so, they're both sleeping right now. I've got it on pause. And, honestly, I don't remember what I did with them last time. I know I had Casey talk to these neighbors over here. Don't know where they are at the moment. Yeah, I got her that chess set, and I didn't even get her any chairs. But she doesn't have much interest in it anyway. So, let's speed up time for a bit, because she needs to... Wait a minute. Yeah, I know, I gotta teach them tricks. Let's see, you... Okay, your energy is fine. You know, he's not sleeping. So, what about you? Okay, so... Yeah, I gotta get her energy up. Pause by accident. Now you can control the time with the D-pad. And you can tell just above it... just above those buttons are her tasks, and basically after I tell her to sleep, I was gonna have her bathe. And I gotta get her energy up first, because if I don't, my sim will collapse. Hehe. And as for the dog, he's probably vying for attention right now, but he's mostly in the green as far as his mood. Yeah, I switched from Casey to the dog with the triangle button. And I can cancel out all of their tasks with the circle button. So yeah, I've got to get her energy up. And... Wait a minute. See, I'm going to sleep for work. 6 hours. Okay, she's got time. Wait a minute. Who is that? That's a car. Someone... Wait a minute. Okay, so she feels like getting up. No, go on. And as for you... Ooh, your bladder's low. Come here. Don't go in the house. I'm not a huge fan of how you can speed up time in this either. It's so much better in The Sims 1. And yeah, blame my laziness for not doing that. You know, instead of doing this one, oh, I gotta get her to... Oh, Nimbus, that's what I named him. Okay, there we go. Didn't even check what his name was. It doesn't matter. As long as he eats. So yeah, rewards. I haven't really been paying much attention because I've been trying to get used to these controls and stuff. So much different. It's so different from the original. There's so much more because, you know, now they have, they already have like distinct personalities. What's your hunger? Your hunger is just fine. They already pretty much have, like, just... Okay, you know what? That's good enough already. Go eat. Come on, go. Go! Get up! They already have, like, distinct personalities, but in here it's a lot more apparent. It's a lot more apparent because they have, like, specific ambitions. Like, in the first one, you could give them a job and... You know, they would have certain skills that they would need to build. And, you know, they would get promotions based on what they did and based on how many friends they had. And it's basically the same here. But now they have more ambition. They're more ambitious. Like, for example, my Sim here wants to be a cook. Like, I gave her a job. As you can tell from the hat. As you can tell from here, I made her a cook. And she had... You can tell from this here that she has one cooking skill. I made her a cook because she aspires to be a cook. And she also has an interest in art. So at the same time, I've been having her go down to the library and study art. Now, that's actually another difference. You can actually see them travel somewhere. Oh, and it's also the same, like, when they're cooking. You see this bar above her head, and that's basically her skill points. So as she cooks, not only is she, like, helping her needs, she is also building her cooking skills. Now, skill points in cooking aren't the only thing that a Sim needs for a job, but this will help with her getting a promotion. I just wish she'd hurry up, because her hunger is really low. Should probably get her to get rid of this, though. Have a pancake. Put away leftovers. Right, go on. I don't know why eat has to be a separate one. In the old one, they did it automatically. And yeah, blame my laziness for not doing the first one first. I am very impatient, and that takes forever to load. This is actually the console version of The Sims 3. I'm actually not playing this on the computer. So eventually I will do that. Let me just put the color. Oh, and they also have challenges. I actually forgot about that too. And when I get better at this game, I'll check that out. Now, while she's eating, actually, we can have her turn that on. While she's eating, I can explain her needs. Now, in the original, you see that there's six listed. In the original, there's eight. Now, the two that they... the two they omitted is room and comfort. And basically, room would be like... Like, Sims preferred to be in an area with a lot of light, and, basically, like, a clean area. Anywhere that they love to be, that would pretty much improve their, room score. The other is comfort, and pretty much what she's doing now, she's just sitting, that would improve her comfort score. Especially if she's sitting on a couch that's especially comfortable. Hence the word comfort. But, you know, they you can't have them, like, stand up for too long. Depending on their personalities, like if they were extremely sloppy Sims, you know, they would be the type of Sim that would always want to sit on the couch. You would really want, like, a comfortable seat for them. So, yeah, I guess they omitted those two because it was a little pointless. Because, you know, once a Sim walked into a new room, you know, basically, that would improve it automatically. Their room score. So, yeah. Oh, wait. No. Got rid of that by accident. Come on, go eat. Go. So, the moods are pretty much self-explanatory. They always start me off with this thing. I don't want to place that anywhere. Now, I'm just doing this to, you know, show it off, because I'm really not going to do much in this. At least not now, anyway. But yeah, this is basically buy and build mode. Now, if you're familiar with the first two Sims games, you can see how much has changed. Walls, floors. Actually, even in The Sims 1, I didn't even pay attention to, like, you know, the type of roof they had. I was mostly concerned with the walls. And back then, I didn't even care much for build mode at all. You know, as long as I'm doing this. Maybe I can find her some inexpensive chairs for that table. Maybe. Come on, get over there. So, yeah. Like I said, it's pretty much self-explanatory. Like, they tell you all the buttons and stuff. And, like, you can open this catalog with the square button. You can reset everything with the circle button. And you actually approach this with the select button. So, if you push start, this menu will show up. This is how you quit or look at tutorials and whatnot. And if you want to enter buy and build mode, you have to push the select button. Possibly move somewhere else. Here's the town map. Maybe I'll show off Casey going to the library, but for the meantime, I want to see if I can get up Nemesis mood. Actually, his mood isn't that bad. He's still in the green. His energy is a little low. Now, like I said, her bladder's low. Your Sims' moods are pretty self-explanatory. Come on down. Yeah, get rid of that. But the pets have actually changed a little bit. So now they have something like destruction. I don't believe that was part of their moods before. I think in the original they pretty much had the same moods as your Sims. So destruction is basically, well, it's self-explanatory. Like, you can't have your pet, you don't want your pet destroying anything. So to keep them occupied, you want to play with them or try to teach them tricks or give them a chew toy. Now, the meter should go up when he does this. Well, if he does it. No, not the ball, not the ball. The toy. Chew the toy. Go. Come on, go. Yeah. You can play with her later. Come on, go. Go. He just wanted to do it. Okay. Come play with Casey, then. Come here. Nimbus always walks. He doesn't come up to her like... He doesn't come running. Okay, he's a tiny pup, I know. But still. Is she just gonna stand there? Come on, play. Maybe she's in the way. Alright, let's cancel that. Don't tell me it's time already. No, it's not. Seriously? I think my sim just went to work. Well, I was hoping she'd play with the dog first. Oh, well. Now, here is... Actually, I really don't want you to go there. I don't care. Here is another difference. You can actually follow your Sims to work. Now, I'm still kind of getting used to it. You can't really do much. I mean, you probably can. I'm just still getting used to this. It's kind of blind. But you know what? It's just as well. This is perfect timing because I did want to show off the Sims actually going somewhere. Well, and by the way, these are basically your friends or your acquaintances or whatever. And, you know, I really don't have to explain this much if you are familiar with the Sims already. Her energy's a little low, though. Mean. All it does is mean. It just says mean. It doesn't say, like, you know, talk or anything. So, yeah, this is where she works. And as I said, I made her a cook. Like, I don't really know how much I can show you as of now. When I get better used to these, I can, you know, show you... You know, what she actually does at work. Or, you know, how it looks at work. But yeah, you can pretty much follow your Sims. Now, in the Sims 1, you could go to other places, but you had to install other expansion packs. And this is the console version, so I really... Okay, well, you can install stuff. I mean, this is the PS3, so you can go on PSN and download stuff. Plus, this is actually... The Sims 3 Pets. So it's not like it's actually, you know, even the base game or anything. But yeah, Casey is in there, and I really can't do anything. So, maybe we should just go home. Now, correct me if I'm wrong in the comment section, because, like I said, this is partially blind. Okay, what are you doing? Are you peeing over there? You want to play with your toy? I wanted to show off using the chew toy, but he doesn't want to do it. Why don't you want to do that? point, but I'm gonna move this thing. Okay, let's go back to live mode. Okay, if it doesn't work now, I'm gonna have him go to the bathroom and then I'm gonna just have him sleep because his energy is really low. It's not really low, but slow enough for concern. Okay, finally, I guess that dish was in the way. Now, I wanted to show this off because of the new destruction meter. Now, I am not that familiar with The Sims 2. I do have one Sims 2 game, but I mostly just played Sims 1. And I wanted to try The Sims 3. This was actually a gift from someone. So he knew I had an interest in The Sims, so he got me The Sims 3. And I really appreciate it, so thank you. You know, it's really, The Sims 1 is the one that I grew up with. But I do like how in The Sims 3, you can actually get the pets to do things other than just, you know, move places. And I do like how the meters have changed. So, you know, this destruction thing, you know, it's going up because he's basically, you know, he's trying out his teeth on this thing, not on the furniture or anything. So, actually, I don't want to switch. Just, so, let's just have him come here and actually, I'm going to have him come out here. I'm going to have him go to the bathroom. I'm going to have him go to sleep. And then I'm going to end the part. Now, I say end the part, but I don't know if I'll do any other videos of this one. Because I did make another family. So if I do another video, it'll probably be with them. Yeah, let's just see Nimbus coming out here. Oh yeah, here's another difference from The Sims 1. You can actually have your Sims have vehicles or a bike. And I gave Casey a bike. I don't think you necessarily need that to travel anywhere, but I got her a bike anyway. So if you want to go to the library or go to the museum, park, anywhere, you can actually just have them leave town. So you see these arrows here. You just basically move over to the arrows and, you know, you have the option to leave. Or you can select the town map. So come on, Nimbus. Come sleep. Yeah, I thought I named him Two-Tone, but I think I named one of the other dogs Two-Tone, because I gave the other family, I think, two or three dogs. So, yeah, here's my one family. See how well Nimbus sleeps. Casey is at work. Oh, I didn't even have her make her bed. Ah!